They are skillful.
Hello, art family, and thanks as always to the new subscribers. Recently, a company that produces brushes reached out to me and asked if I'd be interested in doing a review or a demo with some of their brushes. So I thought I would do this little demo and then give some thoughts on the brushes. They sent me this set of Kolinsky Sable brushes. They're long handle brushes, which is much longer than I'm used to using, but I actually was glad they did because I think it was kind of an interesting experience in using a long handled brush. I typically use the kind of smaller watercolor brushes, but these are longer handles, which I liked because you can hold them far back to get really organic marks, like if you're doing trees or things like that. So I was really interested in that. I was interested to test out if it had like the type of bounce it has. I use sable brushes every day and I really like them, as well as squirrel hair brushes. And one of the things that it takes a while to get used to with those is that they typically don't bounce back into form. So I'm testing out to see how this brush snaps back to form. And I actually felt like it did really well. It was handled the water similar to a synthetic. A synthetic will always kind of snap back into form, where the sable brushes I have tend to fold over, like, and it looks like you're painting with a hockey stick. Usually I'll have people will comment on that who do my workshops or demos, because I've gotten used to the sort of bend of the natural hair brushes and then either using that for texture or just rolling it in my palm or on the side of the page to get it back into form. I did feel like these snapped back into form, but they also splayed out enough that you could get rid of enough water to rough up an area and create an interesting texture. To buy these brushes, it looks like the set is about $20, which to me is really interesting that it can be that cheap, because most of the brushes I have that are sable are really, really expensive, like prohibitively expensive for most people. And I usually don't recommend people use sable because it's so expensive. And I know when I first got a set of sables, I spent months not using them because I found them more frustrating than worth using. So I usually recommend people get synthetics, but this is like a nice in between. It is a sable, I guess, but it handles similar to a synthetic, and then it's very versatile in the movement you can get out of it. It still retains quite a bit of water. I was able to cover a large area. These are relatively small brushes compared to what I like to use. I tend to use an 18 and above, and then some. I'll finish up with a smaller 12. For details. And the biggest brush in this set is a 12, which is fine, and I felt like it handled really well. So I ran it through some tests, just seeing if I could do some swatches and get some even color and control the water. I felt like it controlled really well, and I felt like I was able to get some interesting long straight lines because it retained enough water, yet also used the rough side of the brush and kind of mashed the brush in to get some interesting textures as well. So for this kind of experiment demo, I decided to just go straight for it and see what I could get out of these brushes. So I couldn't quite get as thin a mark as I would like, but that could partially be just because I tend to be pretty heavy-handed with the way I treat brushes and mark making. So I used only the watercolor brushes and the watercolor to create this instead of drawing it ahead of time. I kind of laid out the contour line, starting with an eye line and then building from there. I'm trying to work wet into wet to see how things handle. Another thing that I run into with the regular sables I use is I tend to flood areas if I'm not very careful about getting rid of the excess water. These retain a lot of water, but they didn't retain so much. It's more of an issue with squirrel, really. They didn't retain so much that they were flooding it every time I set them down. So just a little tap, I could get rid of enough excess water that I could work wet into wet to try to keep all these edges quite soft. I chose this reference photo from a recent trip to Alaska because it had a lot of trees in it. So I thought it would be a good chance to see getting long, thin, horizontal marks, as well as getting these rough textured marks in the trees. A lot of what I'm experimenting with now is trying to see what kinds of marks I can get out of scumbling. So pushing the brush in, dabbing it off on a paper towel to get rid of the water so that it's dry, dry brushing in marks, pulling with the form of the hill, just to try to see the kinds of marks I can get out of this. Also, what kind of variety of marks I can get between thick and thin. So that's going to be it for this little test and demo using golden maple brushes. All in all, I was really impressed with them, and I do plan to continue to use them. It does take a little getting used to with the longer handles, but I do appreciate they were solid brushes. So thanks very much to Golden Maple for sending out the brushes, and thank you for watching. I'll see you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.